Hi, this is Variety Chenevert for AKASHI Media Podcast Live, giving you an update on our listenership list. Woo-wee! We're up to 76 countries listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live with Variety Chenevert, the daughter of Florence Ballard, Nicole Renee Roslyn. Everyone called me Roslyn when I was growing up. Ballard. Thank you. Y'all so beautiful. I'm blessed. I feel so blessed to be heard globally, around the world. My voice that beautiful and pretty, y'all. Y'all like my voice that much? Oh, y'all make me feel so good. I feel so good. I'm blushing. Oh my God. Oh my God. I can't stop smiling. Oh. You know, I try so hard to be positive, but we have some days on these segments. Like my last few segments, I've been focusing on the R. Kelly trial, you know. He's my childhood friend, but you know, hey, I still try to be positive. I try to be uplifting in the darkest hour. I try to at least show some love, you know, throw out some mantras out there, some Taoism mantras, you know, some Buddhism, you know, to get people to feel good. And I'm not saying to go out and run out to be Buddhist or anything like that. I just like the mantras because they, you know, they remove blockages. They're about healing, you know, trying to remove financial blockages, people going through things with the COVID. They're not working. So I try to be so uplifting. I try to be healing in my own way to the universe, to the world, you know. So I feel that's one of my callings, is to be uplifting. Because, oh my God, I just like feeling better myself when I do something. So I like other people to feel better too, you know. So I just want to say thank you. Some of these countries I've never heard of, and I have to look up on the internet to where they are, and I'm going to pronounce their country name the best way I can here. But starting off, America, USA, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Brazil, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Ireland, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Algeria, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Russia, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Japan, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Germany, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. United Kingdom, UK, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Israel, woo! I try to keep it real, you know it. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Canada, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Spain, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Italy, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. China, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Morocco, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. France, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Egypt, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Romania, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Netherlands, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Switzerland, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. India, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Nigeria, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Panama, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Mexico, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Philippines, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Mozambique, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Colombia, Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Czech Republic. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Argentina. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Belgium. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Singapore. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Ghana. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Sudan. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Australia. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Syria. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Lebanon. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Norway. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live in Burkina Faso. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Cameroon. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Sweden. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Benin. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Guatemala. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Ivory Coast. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Costa Rica. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Gabon. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Dominican Republic. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Puerto Rico. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Saudi Arabia. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Uruguay. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Hashemite Kingdom. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Hungary. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Denmark. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Tunisia. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Kenya. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Portugal. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Taiwan. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live, Brazil. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Did I see these already? Got so many of them. Uganda. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Germany. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Colombia. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Peru. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Slovakia. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. And let me just make sure I got everybody on my list. Let me see and make sure I got everybody. France. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Russia. Thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Philippines, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. And Malaysia, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Dominican Republic, we have you already. And I said Nigeria, right? Nigeria, thank you for listening to AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Thank you all so very much. I am so blessed to be heard around the world in all your countries. Thank you for allowing me to be in your homes, your headphones, heard in your car, download, streaming, podcasts, internet radio, everywhere. You can also find an audio version of my podcast is on AKASHI Media Channel 1217, and our WordPress is akashimedia.wordpress.com as well. And if you'd like to ever send me an email, you may do so at akashimedia which is AKASHI, Akashi. And Akashi means beautiful. Akashi means beautiful in Swahili. And so I try to give you beautiful media as much as possible. And so you can read our WordPress. It's also on akashimedia.wordpress.com as well. And if you ever want to do a sponsorship and send us a donation, you can do so by going on our website to akashimedia.anchor.fm. And we're also on SoundCloud. We're on Apple. We're on Amazon Music. We're on Google Podcasts. So wherever you might want to donate or do any sponsorships, just push the button for sponsorships and downloads. Thank you so much. I truly appreciate you. And this is Variety, the Spice of Life. Chenevert, also known as Nicole Renee Ballard, the daughter of the late Supreme Florence Glenda Ballard, my mama. Thank you so much, and continue to listen to Akashi Media Podcast Live. Take care. Thank you for listening. Bye-bye. Till next time.
Sunrise, what about rain? What about all the things that you said we were to gain? What about killing fields? Is there a time? What about all the things that you said was yours and mine? Did you ever stop to notice all the blood we've shed before? Did you ever stop to notice this crying earth, this weeping shore?
Hi, this is Variety Chenevert for AKASHI Media Podcast Live. The California Tropical Storm 2023, it's over. I was in it. A lot of people were in it. And I'm a survivor. And a lot of survivors are here today. It's Monday, the 21st of August, 2023. The sun is out. It's lit, sunny, bright again. But however, it was a scary 24 hours because we were worried about those winds. We were worried about those winds getting from 39 to 60 to 120 miles per hour winds. And the Gushan wind coming through, came through last night. I felt that. You could feel that push. It was a push, push, push. It was pushing its way through. It came twice. But it passed us quickly, but with a push. But we're here. I have experience in working in security, and I have a California Guard card through BCIS, and I'm a retired security. However, I still keep my license active, and I told some people that I know and didn't know, and people who didn't know what to do because there wasn't any help, there wasn't any shelters, there wasn't any churches open, there wasn't any evacuation plan, there wasn't anything in place in Los Angeles. So I told them, go to the train station, go to the airport, because there's security there. So if anything needs to be moved and there'll be movement, they'll have to move everyone as a group. And so that'll be the best thing to do. Because of the news of what we were getting, I knew by the way that they were explaining, by moving people from rivers, that that let me know that there wasn't going to be much done about those who were like in the inner city of Los Angeles, Beverly Hills, so on and so forth, was Hollywood. And then they came back to the news and they said that, well, you know, there are people out there that could, you know, die out there. And it really made me feel like that they felt like that people are just going to have to die. It might just have to die because we just can't do anything right now for them because there's nothing open and available for us to really place all these people in, so on and so forth. And that was that way of kind of like saying to me that the population needed to go down somewhat. So God had favor over us. Those who had housing and those who didn't have housing, I'm just glad that we didn't have 120 miles per hour wind in California during a tropical storm. That was the blessing that we needed. We were really concerned about those that were homeless. You know, we were concerned about them before when they had the COVID. There were more people died that had homes and very few that died that had COVID that were outside the entire time. So, you know, that's usually how it works. So God does have favor over the homeless nationwide. However, you know, it's still good to leave your home and go somewhere else because someone has sent me a text message asking me why would I want people to leave their homes? I said, well, you know, some cities are not as good as other cities that keep things updated underneath the ground. You don't know how updated things are underneath the ground. Some cities have a lot of flooding, some do not. That all depends on their plumbing and how their city is taking care of things with the drains and things and so forth like that. That plays a big part. You never know when an earthquake can come about during storms, and it did hit. An earthquake did come. It didn't come in Los Angeles. It was outside. It was in Algie. So that was like Ventura. It was away. Same place that it was before when it had the King earthquake. It was a little bit of, I think the King earthquake was about 5 as well back then in 94 or 8. Something like that, but we didn't feel the earthquake. But that's the reason why people should leave their homes, because you just never know. When you have glass and then there's storms and you don't know what's going to happen with an earthquake, you can have a gas eruption. and a gas eruption would make explosions for miles with homes. And having glass in your home, if you're sitting by the table or sitting on your bed or so on and so forth, that glass can go straight into you. So that's the reason why I would tell people to leave their homes, because I tell them that, you know, when you're a homeowner and you buy a home, you have home mortgage insurance. You have mortgage insurance when you first buy your home anyway, when you get it closed in escrow. And then, you know, homeowners usually have home insurance. So you can always go back if you lose your home and it crumbles or however it may be, and lose part of your home. You can always rebuild your home, but you can never get your life back. So try to understand that you can always rebuild your home. You can always go to the city hall and find out who the architect was of your home, and you have insurance, and or go to the city and they'll give you the blueprints of your home, and they'll let you know, you know how to rebuild again. And you can rebuild with insurance the same way you bought your home, the same layout and everything, you know. And it's better to do that. Sometimes taking a loss is not so bad, but if you have insurance, you'll get everything back, you know. Take what you can, you know. Going to the airport for a couple hours or whatever and being around other people is safer, and having security around you, and it's easier to be able to maneuver and know what's going on the outside, you know, so you're not in the dark and, you know, and don't seem least important when it could be, you know. So that's the reason why I tell people they should not always be at home when they have really high storms. And I had alerts all day on my phone. This is dangerous, life-threatening. And it came up on my phone all day, all morning, early in the morning. It was beeping, 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 beeping all day. So those are the type of things that you want. And it's always good to be someone who doesn't get rid of the old. I mean, the winds, we were really concerned about the winds because a lot of people have mobile homes. That means the mobile homes were dangerous to be in. Even if you had a mobile home, you know, they can move. And you just don't know how that wind is going to blow, if it's going to be high, because they can move cars, it can move bicycles and things like that, and you don't see things in the wind. It can hit someone, you know. You just don't know how things are going to be. So it's good to be in places like a train station where it's kind of underground, like the Red Line and other train stations that have underground railroad, versus those that have it on top. Those that were on top, the train stopped at 6 p.m. yesterday, but the ones that were underground kept going until 12 midnight. So that's the difference. People were still able to have that movement and maneuver, and I knew that that would happen. And once people realized that this is the way to go, people did it, and I was right. So I could really forecast those type of things because I have the training to do that, and security. And no one got hurt. There were no deaths. A lot of people were all right and fine. And then when you were in the airport or you're in the train station, you have food. You still have stores that might be open. You still have restrooms you can use, so on and so forth. So you're not totally out of not being able to, you know, do what's normal at home, you know. And it's good. So it's helpful. It's helpful, you know. So that's something that I want to say about the California tropical storm. It passed us through, and now we have sunlight, y'all. So we are here. All right, now. So we're celebrating that. All right. So take care. This is Variety Chenevert for AKASHI Media Podcast Live. Giving you a commentary on the California tropical 2023 storm of August. And we made it, y'all. We are here. We're blessed. Thank you, God, for looking after us. Bye-bye.
Thank you. says.